Hello. Thank you for spending some of your time to learn more about the Dell VxRail hyperconverged infrastructure. This video builds off of the VxRail Advantage video that introduced the VxRail HCI System Software with a deeper look at the VxRail API. I will explain the customer challenges we're responding to with this feature and how we can solve them. We will discuss different ways you can access the API, example use cases, and where you can find more information. So let's get started. Every IT organization must keep up with the rapid growth and changes driven by their business. They are pressured to respond to these changes quickly and are often challenged to constantly optimize their services to accelerate delivery times and reduce costs. Automation is one of the possible solutions, but end-to-end data center automation is intricate because legacy IT infrastructure can be complex. To make that work, you need a modern, flexible infrastructure with built-in automation that can be easily integrated with your processes and tools through an API. Many organizations that take a more holistic approach to automation, such as service providers, large enterprises, or customers embracing DevOps and infrastructure as code, require more choice and customization options when it comes to automation. The standard UI-based interfaces requiring human-operator interaction are no longer sufficient. VxRail as an HCI system simplifies data center infrastructure and operations. The integrated HCI system software extends VMware's native capabilities to deliver a seamless automated operational experience. VxRail Manager is a central control plane VM and automation tool for VxRail cluster operations that natively integrates with VMware vCenter. It allows you to deploy, manage, upgrade, add, or remove nodes and perform diagnostics. Customers can manage VxRail systems using native VMware administration tools, such as vCenter. VxRail Manager, which is integrated with vCenter as a plugin, automates all VxRail-specific operations in the background, but this approach still requires the operator's interaction to trigger them. And what if we want these operations to be started automatically as part of a more extensive orchestrated process? This is where the VxRail API comes in handy. So what is the VxRail API? It's a RESTful API running as a service on the VxRail Manager appliance and allows you to execute cluster operations programmatically. Why is this important? Because REST is an architecture that enables you to execute these operations from virtually any automation framework, programming language, or API client of your choice. Regardless of the client, the communication happens using the secure HTTPS protocol. Let me give you a couple of examples. The easiest way to get started is by exploring built-in interactive web-based documentation. It's as simple as opening this URL from a browser, and you'll be presented with an intuitive interface where you can list the available functions, required parameters, sample responses, and even test these functions on a live system. If you're a more advanced RESTful API user or developer, you might be using a dedicated client application, such as Postman. This will give you more options. You would be able to test and save your API queries, more sophisticated workflows consisting of multiple API calls, and environment variables so you can more easily reuse them in the future. Another advantage of this approach is that you can automatically generate code snippets in the programming language of your choice, which is a tremendous help if you're a developer consuming API via code. Another option is using the API from an automation framework of your choice. If you're a Windows Server or vSphere admin, you should be familiar with PowerShell and PowerCLI, an official VMware module for this framework. PowerShell on its own provides standard functions for interacting with REST APIs, but we've made that even simpler by creating the VxRail API PowerShell modules package. It contains wrapper functions for the API, fully integrated into PowerShell, providing you with simpler syntax and built-in help. And if you're using PowerCLI, you'll have a similar end-user experience you are familiar with, and you can use both together. If your organization decides to use an open-source configuration-managed framework to automate their infrastructure, such as Ansible, then we've got you covered there too. These frameworks typically provide standard modules for interacting with REST APIs. In the case of Ansible, it's the URI module. Because we understand how important it is for some of our customers, we make it even simpler for them with our official Ansible modules, which are now available from Ansible Galaxy on GitHub. What's great about these modules is not only that they are maintained and supported, these modules are written so that all the operations are idempotent, meaning that making multiple identical requests has the same effect as making a single request. Idempotency is one of the principles of infrastructure as code, and it is key for customers who would like to embrace this approach for managing their infrastructure. Finally, you can use the VxRail API like any other REST API, simply from a CLI on any operating system by using the curl command. And a CLI might be an option to integrate the API with virtually any automation framework that for some reason might not have a standard module for interacting with REST APIs. Thankfully, even the most basic automation frameworks typically have an option to execute CLI commands on a system. Our customers often ask us how to automate use cases, such as cluster development, scaling out, or LCM upgrades. You can do all of these and even more because the API is very comprehensive. You can automate operations in three categories. System information queries, for instance, how to collect inventory information about the system and its components. Day one operations, everything related to the initial deployment after you power on the system for the first time in your data center. Day two operations, ongoing cluster management tasks, such as adding and removing nodes and upgrading or collecting log bundles and shutting down clusters. We generally focus on VxRail specific operations, and you can extend your capabilities with other APIs from VMware, such as the vSphere Automation API and the VCF on VxRail API. Because vSphere is an integrated component of every VxRail system, you can use that in combination with vSphere Automation API and Power CLI to automate general vSphere operations related to virtual machines, such as creating, cloning, reconfiguring, or migrating VMs. And if you're using VxRail with VMware Cloud Foundation, you can leverage the VCF on VxRail API from SDDC Manager to automate VCF on VxRail operations. In fact, our engineering team works closely with VMware's Cloud Foundation engineering team, and some of the VxRail API functions are integrated into SDDC Manager automation workflows. All of these capabilities are available from the automation framework of your choice, giving you total integration flexibility to maximize the benefits of your existing investments. Let's recap. VxRail API is a RESTful API that allows you to automate VxRail operations programmatically, eliminating the need for a GUI interaction. You can use the VxRail API with an automation tool of your choice, and we make it especially easy for PowerShell and Ansible users. This way, you can automate your processes to save time, reduce errors, and create better use of your existing investments. As you customize the level of automation to the needs and standards within your organization, you will become more agile in answering the needs of your business. To learn more, please visit this URL, where you will find all the resources you need to get started. Thank you for watching.